والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. ثم أما بعد، ما زلنا في الحديث عن آداب السلام في الإسلام، ومعنا مسألة وهي السلام على المرأة الأجنبية أي غير ذات المحرم. السلام على المحرم لا بأس، يعني ليس فيه شيء طبعا. أما السلام على المرأة الأجنبية التي ليست من المحارم أو لا تملك بصر، حقيقة المسألة فيها كلام كثير بين أهل العلم، منهم من أجازه مطلقا ومنهم من منعه مطلقا، ولكن يعني بعضهم يعني توسط في الأمر وقال يعني أنه شروط. إن كان السلام يعني لا يخشى معه الفتنة يعني ولا يجر إلى شيء بعد يعني ما بعده، فلا حرج ولا بأس، خاصة إن كان يشعر بنوع من الأمن والطمأنينة. بعضهم قال إن كانت شابة يعني غير المرأة العجوز، وبعضهم قال يعني أن هو يلقي السلام ولكن المرأة لا ترد بصوت عالي، فقد يكون في صوتها يعني فتنة أو نحو ذلك. فالأمر يعني فيه نوع من المحاذير وفيه يعني ضوابط كثيرة، يعني كثيرا طبعا ما نلقي التحية على جيراننا وعلى الناس يعني وليس هناك فتنة وليس هناك شيء، فلا حرج في ذلك. أما إن كان السلام هذا يعني له ما بعده ويخشى من توادع قد يؤدي إلى أمور أكثر، فلا ينبغي إلقاء السلام. والله سبحانه وتعالى أعلم. We're still talking about the greeting in the Islam, and we have a subject very important today. What about to give salam to the foreign women? It's not from your relative or it's not from your mahram. So some scholar يعني said no way, you don't have to do it, and the other said it's okay, you can do it, and in between some said there are some conditions there. If that salam, when you say assalamu alaikum, it will not be any fitna there, any trial, any something wrong, it's okay. They said that the woman, if she was beautiful and her voice can be a kind of trial, so she don't have to ply with a loud voice. And if you are, if you know that maybe when you say assalamu alaikum, that can lead you to something else. How are you? Then after how are you? What's going on? Then you start to talk and then so on and so on. That's in this case, you don't have to do it. So it's up to the conditions, up to the condition. Of course, talking about يعني the salam as assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I know in here in America or in the West, we meet our neighbor, the women I mean, in the shopping, you know, they say hi, they say hello, they say, I think this is something regular and normal, nothing wrong with that. And by the way, you have to watch your attention, Allah knows your attention. So just for something, you know, hi, hello, and that's it, and you are on your way, huh? You will not stop and hello and shake hand and what's going on, and you look at her hair and so. It will be, of course, something different. he has some, there is no evidence, to be honest with you, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to don't make salam upon the women or not. They have some evidence, not that much strong, that he used to, just point with her hand, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, from far away. And Allah Alam, Allah knows best that this is about that evidence, another thing about the greeting the salam upon the kids. Upon the kids. Some people, they feel, or they have kind of arrogance. They don't care about the kids. They insult them. They go from away. Go from here. Go. That's not okay. The Prophet ﷺ used to be kind and nice with the kids, subhanAllah. And he used to make salam upon them, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And he used to play with Al-Hasan and Al-Husayn صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. And we have the hadith in Bukhari and Muslim narrated Anas ibn Malik رضي الله تعالى عنه أنه كان يمشي مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فمر بصبيان فسلم عليهم. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, Anas ibn Malik, and he used to be a servant for the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم more than 10 years. He used to walking with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. When they passed by the kids, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, "Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah." And of course, this means that you are a humble person. You don't see yourself up. And also, it's kind of training. When the kids always they listen and say "Assalamu alaikum," they will be training. They will grow up. They will do the same. They will do the same. What about the one of the most important issues, the people of the book, the non-Muslims, or even here or in our country, the Christian? We have different between greeting in general and between as-salam as a greeting. Okay, when I say good morning, good evening, hi, hello, how are you? It's different between and say assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We have been forbidden to start the people of the book with the assalam as a greeting, assalamu alaikum. But if they will say assalamu alaikum as we have in our country, or sometimes I used to be in the bank yesterday, Wachovia, then a woman there, she said, "You are from where?" I used to wear the dress. I said, "Sir, she's from Egypt." She said, "Salamu alaikum." I said, "Wa alaikum." She's from America here, or from Italy, and she visited Egypt and stayed there, and she has an apartment somewhere. Anyway, she said, "Salamu alaikum." She's not Muslim, she's Christian. I respond, "Wa alaikum." And this is how you respond. Why? Because sometimes you don't say it clear. Of course, yani, I don't say everyone do that. They say "Assalamu alaikum." Sam mean death. The word "Sam," death. As you see, it's close to. If you say it fast, "Assalamu alaikum," and say "Assalamu alaikum." Said "Sam," the Jewish who entered or came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said "Assalamu alaikum, ya Rasulullah." Mean the death upon you, O Allah's Messenger. He didn't say salam. The Prophet said to Aisha, "Okay, it's enough that you respond, wa alaikum. And upon you, whatever you said. You said salam, it will be upon you the salam. Said salam, it will be upon you the as-salam." So if you start, they started you by salam alaikum, say wa alaikum. Okay? But no problem that you start to them with any other kind of greeting. Good morning. Hi, how are you today? Hello, how are you doing? You know, but there's no problem with that. And if they are group, mixed between Muslims and non-Muslim, you said assalamu alaikum and you mean to do it for the Muslim. Now, this is enough today. Inshallah, we have a couple of points tomorrow. What about when you are pray or someone pray and you tell a message, can say assalamu alaikum and he respond? And what about the salam with the appointment with the hand and the one who recite the Quran and the one who is in the bathroom or in the restroom and so on. Inshallah, tomorrow we are going to talk about this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.